Good morning, everyone. Sorry about this problem. Welcome to St. Aloysius Parish on this 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Readings this morning may be found on page 558 of your Sunday Missal. I invite everyone to stand for our opening hymn, the number 640. O God, our help in ages past.
You are Let us sit for the word.
Worth reading.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, maintain justice and do what is right. For soon prayer, their burnt offerings and their sacrifices will be accepted on my altar. For my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus proclaimed the good news.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. A Canaanite woman from that region came up and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord, son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, but even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed instantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I find this a rather interesting repartee between Jesus, the woman, etc. And at first glance, I don't know if I've managed to try to translate the text properly with my voice. But it seems to me that one, women did not accost men in that days, especially not when they were not of your own group, that mean race group. He came and she wanted something. And she wasn't going to leave until she got it. That is faith. He can get my girl, all right. And I will see that he does so. That is real prayer. You say, "I want, I need this." And finally, Jesus gave it to him. But in the meantime, he kind of played with her, trying to make make it more difficult for her. And the reason he did that, and it's not the only time, but every time it's with women, he tried to show to everybody there how much faith that woman had. She wouldn't give up. And this is what we have to do as well. We mustn't give up. We must constantly pray to God. We have things to ask for. We have people we know that need help. We have to pray for them. There are things we need. We have to pray for them and not give up. That's what that woman did. The other woman, by the way, was the one who had blood problems. I mean, she was losing blood. And she said in herself, "If I can just touch his garment, I'll be killed. And of course, Jesus was being pushed by everybody, and so on and so forth. And then when she touched his garment, he said, "Who touched me?" As if, you know, he could tell. Again, he put that woman on the spot. And why? As an example of faith. This is what we, the kind of faith we have to have. The churches are not full. Okay. Let's pray to fill them and not give up. Our society is secular. We've forgotten about God. We've forgotten about heaven. Let's do something about it. Let's pray. Let's act according to Jesus' ways. We'll be surprised at the result. If perchance you decide to read the text that I wrote in the bulletin today, you will find that it's about a Jewish woman who got killed in the gas chambers. And she knew that that is what was going on with her people. But she was a Carmelite. So she spent her time praying for her people. Praying for her people to be taken up in God. Succeed, and that is why she is one of the patron saints of Europe. One of the three great Theresas, all Carmelites, Teresa of Avila, Therese de l'Enfant Jésus, and now Teresa Benedicta of the Cross. She knew she had to give her life for her people. And she did. Because the reason she was taken to Auschwitz was because she was in, at that time, the Netherlands, and the bishops of the Netherlands complained to the Nazis that this wasn't something to be done. To kill the Jews. The Nazis learned, please. So the first thing they did is take together all the Catholic Jews, all those who had converted, and send them to death. And tell the bishops, mind your own business. You see what we can do? Then people will wonder why the church was reasonably silent during the Holocaust. It's because some people were ready to show that they had power. And this is not the way the church goes. We don't have. We have weakness, but it's through weakness that God's power will succeed.
Let us raise for our creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the church and its leaders, called to hear and to proclaim the words of the prophets, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations willing to risk the prophetic task of establishing peace and justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are poor, sick, and persecuted, and for all who minister to them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. Aloysius community, called in baptism to be a people of prophetic words and actions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our parish family and among our loved ones who are ill, suffering, or in convalescence, especially Carol Guillon, Bobby Squires, Clarice Mascarenhas, John Henry, Mathilde Alias, Cyril Clément, Maria Malorni, Pierce Corsi, Diane Vanning, Ginny Whalen, Patricia Chancy, Alan and Melvin Crook, and Father Peter Laviolette, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Please keep Pierce Corsi in your prayers this week, as he will undergo a series of scans on Friday, August 25th. May he remain cancer-free. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. We also pray for Jean-Paul Lafontaine and for Betty Trottier on the fourth anniversary of her passing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own personal and private intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us ask Mother Mary to join us in our petitions. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. The offertory hymn is number 717, Whatever You Do.
Peace of mind.
Dear brothers and sisters, we do not have priests to celebrate the Eucharist according to the rite set by Holy Mother the Church. On the other hand, we have consecrated hosts available for us to partake of the body of Christ. Unfortunately, I didn't know if we were going far enough, so there are some who are in cutting two. Before though, let us remember how they became the body of Christ. Let us remember what the Lord Jesus left us as an everlasting memorial. We can share and drink this cup of wine, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. Our Lord then added, "This is the cup of my blood, the blood of a new and everlasting covenant, which will be shed for all for the forgiveness of sins." He also urged us to remember these actions and words until he comes again by the admonition, "Do this in memory of me." This is not the only thing we must remember. We must never forget that Jesus gave his life for us all, was crucified, suffered a terrible death on Good Friday, but rose from the dead on Easter Sunday, and now lives forever. We must never forget that Jesus told us that God is not only his Father, but also our Father, that we are to love each other and everyone just like he did by giving himself up for all. We must let God our Father make us like his beloved Son by this partaking together of the bread which is his body. We must also never forget that we are an active part of the Church on earth. And so we pray for our Pope Francis, for our Bishop Lucien, for our priests, for each other in this congregation, in this parish, indeed, for everyone in this whole world, whether friend or foe, good or evil. We must always give thanks to God for God's love for us, for our families, our friends, and all the world. Before we receive communion, let us say all together that prayer that Jesus left us. So with one voice, let us proclaim, "Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil."
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other sign of peace.
take the greatest of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take the greatest of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take the greatest of the world, grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and the work of the Holy Spirit, through your death gave life to the world, free us by this your most holy body and blood from all our sins and from every evil. Keep us always faithful to your commandments, and never let us be parted from you. Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and your soul shall be.
Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Good morning.
Hi. Good morning.
Just to remind you that at the end of each Mass, we're at the back. I would have asked it for being the whole. So whatever change you want to give us, we'll take it. On top of that, once again, just want to remind you that we are holding a 50-50 to raise funds for the Back to School project. The raffle will be sold during the month of June, July and August. So this week, and before Mass next week, after Mass next week will be the draw. The tickets are $1 each, and I wish you all good luck. So far, we have raised just a little over $1,000 for the Back to School project. So I would like to thank you all. And that is not counting.
We're very glad so many of you stay after Mass for a chat and refreshments. We kindly ask that as of 10:30, we try to keep our voices down, since some of the parishioners from St. Louis are praying. On nice days, we can also gather outside the front doors if you wish to stay longer. We encourage all our new parishioners to join us, as it's a way to get to know each other. Thank you for your understanding and cooperation. May I thank everybody who came today. It's nice to see you here. It's nice to all be praying together. There are a few birthdays. On the 20th, Francis Mascarenhas. On the 20th, Bob Trottier. On the 22nd, Franco Giglio. And on the 25th, Lynn Kraka. And so, we say, happy birthday to you.
Protect us from all evil and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen.